Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about our BDA build plans. We offer a lot of kits in the DIY section of our website, and you can go there on our homepage and look at all the products that we offer in the shop. So I want to walk through those build plans that we offer so that you have kind of an overview and understanding about what they really are and what they really can do for you. First off, they're build plans, not blueprints. They're plans to give you an idea of what you're up against in terms of measurements, sizes, materials, and things like that, layout, assembly. But they're not specifically measured to show you exactly this piece is this long and this piece is that long. You have to do your own layout because you have to decide what is best for you. And it's too many variables for too many people to have one size fits all. And in acoustics, you know that that's really a rare thing. What does BDA stand for? Broadband Diaphragmatic Absorber, 30 to 400 cycle range. So that's its frequency response. That's one of our first, the BDA drawings are our eighth prototype construction in a series of 12. The 12th, the 11th, and the 12th are the products that we offer on our website with the carbon technology. The BDA does not have the carbon technology inside. The carbon technology boosts the performance of the BDA by 25%. We do not license the technology anymore or give it out like we used to in the beginning, but it is available through purchase with our production units. So you have the diaphragmatic process. Let's go over it that. So the cabinet depth, we have three parts to it. We have the cabinet depth, and then we have the cabinet strength or mass, and then we have the front wall construction. So there's really three parts to the cabinet. And you know that our diaphragmatic absorbers have that dual front wall and then the carbon in the middle here. And the cabinet has a specific depth, it's air spacing and all of that. So you have the two front walls, one and two, and then you have the filter, the carbon filter here. And you can go on our website and see how all that works. And then the cabinet rigidity or strength. Cabinet can, in this case, it's a 1-inch MDF we use in the BDA drawings. And then you can add more density to the back. You can add more density to the sides. Just depends on your needs and how much coverage you have. So that's why they're build plans and not blueprints, because one size does not fit all. So we have the internal, the depth of it determines the frequency of residence. Okay, what does that mean? That means, let's say the frequency of residence is 30 cycles. So everything above 30 will be absorbed. Everything below 30 will not be. So, but we're happy with 30 to 400 because that's the problems most rooms face anyway in the lower end. The internal fill material or the carbon, or if you're building it yourself without the carbon, the foam is directly responsible for how much energy it absorbs at within that frequency range. So if you get the right balance between cabinet rigidity, the dual front wall construction, and the absorber in the middle, then you know you get a nice balanced product that produces predictable and consistent results, and you can see those on our website. Riverbank Labs test results on our website, you have to deduct about 25% off those numbers because you're not going to be using carbon in the BDA. Okay. So the face, obviously, you can put foam on the face. So you can put foam here, and what is foam? That's a middle and high frequency absorber, okay? So you can really get yourself in a position, if you put our foam on the front, you can get an absorber that goes from 30 to 6,500. That's pretty broad band. So you get a low frequency absorber, and you get a middle and high frequency absorber all of it up to 6,500. And the rates of absorption are incredible. It took a long time to figure those out. Okay, so the internal fill cabinet material, that determines the amount of absorption that you occur, the depth of the cabinet, and then the cabinet rigidity all work together. Now, how many BDAs do I need in my room? I get this question a lot. Unknown. You have to send me your room dimensions. You have to fill out the room form. We have to look at the diameter of the low frequency drivers. We have to look at the pressure levels that you listen to music at. We have to look at your room size and volume. So many variables that we have to look at. That's why I came up with the room form. So if you're considering buying the BDA plans, fill out the room form, and then I can help you and tell you how much square footage you're going to need, and more importantly, where to put it. So I can tell you how much you're going to need to build and where to put it. And of course, that's important. You're always going to need more than two units. Two units at a minimum, you know, three units, four units. Four units seem to be about the average. Some rooms need six, some need eight. So you want to know all that before you start the process, because it's easier to build four units at once than it is one, because the cutting and the pieces and everything will be the same. So BDA build plans, hope that helps. If you buy them, have any questions, email me or call me and I'll walk you through them. Buy the plans, study them for reading and comprehension. Put together a list of questions, send me an email or call me. Thank you. I hope you enjoyed our videos today, and if you did, we really would appreciate a thumbs up from you. If you have any questions or comments, you can go to the comment section, or you can go to our website, acousticfields.com, and fill out the contact form. Subscribe to our channel, our YouTube channel. We're now doing two videos a week. If you have some ideas for topics, you can submit those to us also. If you're having room issues, we have that free room analysis. You can click on the button below and we'll compare your room to our database of 120 built rooms that we built and actually measured, and I guarantee you your room is in that database. So just click on the button below for the free room analysis. Thank you.